What did I say to piss you off this time? Baby!
Who is the Negro in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, I say, who is the Negro in your neighborhood when you're running from his ass each day?
Black people don't hope, we wish.
Something that crazy could only come from you.
Right now you live in belief. You want to believe things. Belief is ignorance. Right knowledge is to know. Understand that? Belief is ignorance because belief is the acceptance of things that you do not know. And every one of your prayers end with amen.
Let me hear you say amen. Oh, let me hear you say amen.
Amen, which is the ancient Egyptian god, Amun, and the rock was the sun in us as original people of the sun. And we roamed the earth millions of years, 17,250,000 years exact, before Adam was created 49,000 years ago. Now, we don't know good people from bad. We don't know good food from bad. We don't know good music from bad. We don't know anything, and we were the ones who knew everything. And so they put us under a spell. What kind of spell? The spell of ghost worship. You understand? Ghost worship. And they said gospel. Ghost spell. All you know is what they told you, and you have belief in what they told you. When we were in our right state, state of Elohim, we didn't have beliefs. We knew, because we were the gods that everybody worshiped. They made us hate the rising of the sun. By telling us, make sure you don't make fudge while the sun is rising. That's because we were sun people. People trying to get away from the sun made us start hating the sun. How'd they make you hate your hair? No, by telling you to pick cotton. The moment we start conking our hair and cupping our hair and putting our feet on the grass again, things are going to start opening. We lost our eye and our light.
Whoa. Yeah, that's right. From New York to Jamaica to Canada, Japan to Algeria to Paris, the Norway to Belgium, Doma Doma, Mexico, cool. Live from Ground Zero. That's right, babies. Y'all know where this is at. That's right. It's the fastest 30 minutes on air. Your radio show on Bust That Ass, 83.17 FM X. And of course, needless to say, the X stands for You Never Saw Me Coming When You Never Saw Was Zach Dumbass. Your Black Lenny Bruce on the loose, who's better than that bowling mini me, 2 pump chump of a boyfriend. And yes, I run rings around that ass like flat ass, I might say, like Saturn. So test me, bitch. And if I say anything to offend you, then you know I'm doing my motherfucking job, because you have the option of turning me off when I keep turning you on again and again and again. Like smoking kush on the steps of City Hall in front of an army of cops, and they can't do shit. Cash ass, that's right, bitches. Y'all know how I start this shit straight up on a fucking Tuesday. Alrighty. LA Aces Entitlement, you know how the question goes like this. Ha ha. Does the practice of extortion become so evident that if you're a poverty worker by 2030, you know, a little bit like 20 years from now, will we be able to get out of poverty quicker than China? Or how in the fuck does Cali whack ass get away with rape and abuse against his poor when you have a bunch of nepotistic dumb motherfuckers who keep giving up the ass with no lube? You be the judge. Time for school, peeps. Motherfuckers is getting robbed and cheated while the state makes billions to gloss an image of partiality and biasness. As racist as this fuckhole is, the standing mood of white-collar crime against the poor is a method found only in the 48 levels of power. In this corrupt nation of the poor making the rich better, the practice of extortion is so widespread it's fucking pandemic. Check it. The very definition of extortion is this: a criminal offense of unlawfully obtaining money, property, or services from a person, entity, or institution through coercion. In other words, they have to make you decide either you take life or death. That's how they make their decisions, all right? It is also often used loosely to refer to everyday situations where one person feel indebted against their will to another in order to receive an essential service or avoid legal consequences. With less than 18 days before the fiscal cliff becomes a bottomless pit of class warfare, many people who have relied on their unemployment benefits, general relief, and food stamps will be billed by the state that you owe that money back to them. Thus, you work in the system as a goddamn slave, and then there's work available at all. Ageism is the nexus against the retirement age. We're currently at 75. That means that if you're over 40, you're suspect to minimum wage, and naturally that's $8 an hour. There's no way to get insurance. There's no way to move up in a transient job market. And there's certainly no help from the miles of red tape and confusing animation of sudden terminology and what is the rule to exception. Such practices of legal Jim Crow advocate under the auspices of financial segregation, which keeps my profile at bay in Beverly Hills as a vagrant to the economy. What the fuck? I know where I was going with that. Okay, the real deal is that it doesn't matter the color. It matters the perception of your demographic. Yes, you are judged before anything in the process. So who in the fuck is responsible for such cultural legislation? Here's a list of names and see if you can recognize the flabby bastards and bitches. The LA County Board of Supervisors. That's all you need. Whoa. You don't even have to go any further than that now, do you? Really? Cheryl Spiller, executive director of the whole shebango. At an annual salary of $245,000 since August 2011, Spiller has served as acting director of public social services after the former director, Philip Browning, was named to head the Department of Children and Family Services. What strange bedfellows we find, you know? You see, he was the chief child abuser for the Los Angeles County of Child Support Services Department. Browning was also responsible for waiting an entire month to notify over a quarter of a million of his victims when computers were stolen from his West Covina office. Oops! Though DPSS is the second largest locally operated social service agency in the nation, like McDonald's, it serves over 2 million people daily and distributes $3 billion in benefits annually, 85% of which is paid back by extorting the ignorance of the working poor, and only 12% by the government and 3% by taxpayers. And you wonder why the average taxpayer is bloody stupid, and that's spelled with two goddamn O's, on its errant witch hunt against the very motherfuckers who clean their homes and work as slaves in their businesses. Instead of using the whip these days, the threat of unemployment and subjugation under the pretense of extortion means we can never win in a system of equality. Now does it? And at what cost of financial abuse are we, the working poor, still being taxed for as though we're under the threat of a cartel? Need we only look to the faces of those who make the rules in motherfucking Babylon? Think about it. I'll be black after this.
Soundboy! Vindicator on the mix. Scandalous. Scandalous.
Lord of mercy.
Click. Boom, them I enter the room. Trying to catch the yard and pull it in the hill. You don't approve. Everywhere I've been across the land with Roman hand. Try to cut the cover when I'm touching them in gland. No to know that when she come back, when I did that, it's a fact. Catch a dubbin, no, cooking on the spirit. She can tell it when I hear it. Yummy, sip it in a little ganja and she can feel it. Rolling down a tummy, go and let it, cause we don't have to do it. All that bullshit, push the bummy, running from it. When she giving me something in a funky style, it doggy doggy. I got your fucking mad one. Rude boy, I'm the only one that's gonna be the love of your girl. Scandalous, scandalous. Them a don't go in Irish, scandalous. I got your fucking mad one. Rude boy, I'm the only one that's gonna be the love of your girl. Scandalous, scandalous.
Scandalous, scandalous, scandalous.
Oh yes, you know my Skittles Facebook report. Fat bitch, anything? Ah, the stuff I found on my Facebook. Amazing, shocking, but true. This in from Ass Buster Yoko Ono, no relation to David Ono on KABC, but who knows? Out of Japan, a pick post that strikes fear in the very hearts of the Republican industrial complex. It says with her pick in the middle, "War is over." Oh my God, it's over. If that were the case, motherfuckers would be doing a lot more fucking, you know, these days, you know? That's right, straight up sex. What are y'all, afraid of that shit or what? Fucking repressed bastards. This one sent in by Assbuster Invisible Temple. A pick post for bitches who know this shit is coming to a drastic end in its fad. It says, quote unquote, fuck swag. The W in the pick is in the shape of the Wu-Tang insignia, so niggas know the owl, it'd be time for some action. And finally, from Assbuster Amnesty International, a pick post of a great saying that anyone who seeks injustice, okay, if you're seeking injustice, needs to, anyone who sees that shit, needs to speak the fuck up. It says, it's better to light a candle than to curse in darkness. Oh shit, I'm as dark as they come and I love cussing in the daylight! Oh yes, baby, Black Abarca. Let's see if you guys can follow me on this. Tillis, Martin, Davis, Alexander. These are the last names, and if you don't know these names, then it's obvious you're living under a fucking rock or don't care how fast niggas is dying by two things, us and them. Check it. Many of us are still considered a target. In fact, no matter how old you become, being a Black American male walking outside of the environment is always rife with inherent risk, such as crossing the street when Koreans are driving, you know, trying to get around fat bitches who fucking spread their kids out like a fucking Red Rover line, that sort of shit. But, you know, being that I'm the type of man who, because of the history of bigotry in America and its racist roots of gun control, refuse to ever abdicate any right to the state for any reason whatsoever, including my right to keep and bear arms for self-defense. Oh my God, that would make me a gangbanger. Unfortunately, the issue of the express constitutional right of the Second Amendment is confused by the lack of knowledge in history and the ability, rather the inability, fear, and ignorance of some Black Americans to realize, niggas, their right to keep, bear, and effectuate that right via the statutes of several states. Of course, you know I'm gonna say, what the fuck here? I mean, come on. I mean, can anyone name one Black gun manufacturer in their hood anywhere in the United States? No, we don't make the guns, you dumb motherfuckers. We use them. Besides, the gun being a phallic symbol of a short dick bastard, niggas with guns only make up 2% of the total gun population. Yet we make up 45% of our own system of tribal murder rates and 90% of the prison slave population. Talk about ignorance is progress. I have to often ask, what other express conditional right should be either abolished or repealed? Surprisingly enough, no one answered the erosion or abolition of the 13th Amendment, which outlaws slavery and, involuntary servitude. But then again, you know, dumb niggas love being in gangs as much as intelligent niggas that love working for corporate world. It's just the same when it all equates to access.
That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast.
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
I had 3 kids. My 3 kids in a car by themselves until my mama arrived on the scene. They didn't give me my Miranda rights. 11 o'clock payment, 11 o'clock on my phone the next day. Then some man coming in with a piece of paper talking about I wanted to arrest. But I've been here since 4 o'clock p.m. You just now arrested me. It's 11 p.m. to 12 o'clock the next morning. So why am I in here if I wasn't arrested? My brother got shot, like they said, in the back of the head, came through Robert's temple, in the back of the leg, and in the back. Why did you do that? He said you had a gun. And I've been out there for 10 hours, and nobody find no gun, and nobody find the item that they say in the news that he was trying to take. Where the victim at? You just seen, it wasn't even a phone call, said he robbed somebody. You just happened to be going that way and seen an African-American running and start to take the suit. You didn't know what was going on until after he was already dead. So why did you kill him? That's what I want to know.
Watch out! We run through y'all!
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
If
I was here just now and Sarah Arthur threatened, I'm licensed to carry a gun. I murdered someone in here because I felt threatened. There was no gun found with neither one of them. And the only thing that this family has gotten back was because they're the police department and they felt threatened for their lives. And they were licensed to carry a gun. That's injustice. I feel like there needs to be a thorough investigation. The police, whoever is involved, need to be accountable. Each one of us in here has to be accountable for our actions. Why not them? You know, if this family is hurting, imagine if I took someone's life and you imagine your parents not being able to sleep, your kids turning to drugs, your wife losing her mind. It has an effect on everyone. And I feel like there's no effect for them. This family has gone through a lot, and no one seems to even care about the pain. We're part of society, so what we feel is going to reflect on everyone here. Somebody help bandage us. We're hurting. We're crying. We're protesting, speaking out. Anybody, we're crying for help. Somebody, please do something. This is not right.
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
Oh, my God. Dirty condoms. Yeah, I said it's a blog on my website, so check it out. Fucking gutter birds all night and all this morning, I guess. I mean, looking for a drowned borracho. I guess eating McDonald's will drive a motherfucker to suicide, but then again, sausage is pork, bitches. They should have been looking for hoes. They keep forgetting the new hoe report I give here, and guess what? They're coming in from Skid Row this winter. Loads of them, like untagged white rhinos facing extinction. And they're twice as large, too. I mean, damn, I mean, I've seen some biggins, boy. And I mean biggins. Must be feeding them good out there. Oh, and I got mice in my house now. Poopsie been trying to catch the fucking mouse, but, you know, so far the hunt draws no blood, and there'd be blood on the floor if it was the case. But, you know, gotta love fresh kill. Yummers. And I don't have to use my food stamps on it. It's free meat! Oh shit, you know where I'm going with this one. Cultural nepotism. Cultural nepotism in the criminal element is fucking fascinating. Check it. Everybody probably seen this shit already, but you know, police in New York City have released a video showing the gunman they say shot and killed a 31-year-old. Oh my God. Damn, gotta love that kush. A 31-year-old Los Angeles man in a brazen midday shooting near Central Park in Midtown Manhattan. Sounds like the revenge of Biggie Smalls is upon, motherfuckers! Okay, the surveillance video shows a man in a dark hooded jacket. That's damn near fucking description of every last black man in America. Basically, climbing out of a car on 58th Street near the Time Warner Center. Broad fucking daylight, okay? Glancing around and then walking deliberately toward Brandon Water, of the victim, okay? A still shot from the video shows the killer standing behind Woodward. With his hand jammed in his front pocket of his jacket. Woodward appears to be looking at his cell phone, texting or reading a message. Okay, this is what the fuck on stupidity here. Rule number one, ground zero niggas. Y'all ain't got no ghetto buildings out here. So when you're in New York, motherfucker, look up and pay the fuck attention to your surroundings. Central Park, for crying out loud, what was you thinking? Okay, it's a recession and niggas in New York is hungrier than they are here. Of course, motherfuckers is fat as fuck, but then again, It ain't that, and it ain't for that fucking pork cookie either, you know what I mean? But you know what? The funny ass irony of karma in this is, Woodard was convicted of grand theft, a DUI, and a hit and run involving property, all in 2009, according to Los Angeles Superior Court records. He was convicted of petty theft in 2008 and urinating in public in 2006. So the criminal motherfucker was running, okay, and then got his ass blasted on with karma, okay? So you such a badass slash dumbass in this blaxploitation. Pimpalicious got killed by a real killer bee nigga, okay? I think the fat boy said it best. You never gamble in another man's territory. Obviously, he didn't care where he was, or he would have done the same thing and got his ass on the fucking bus like anybody else. Okay, we got a rule in Brooklyn, jackasses. You flash, you get robbed. But since he got smoked, homebrewski looked like it was, a specific hit, and the motherfuckers knew him. I mean, the motherfucker looked out of the car twice. Comes up, look at the circumstances and not the crime. If that had been anyone else, do you think Killer B would have made him out so quickly to recon? Like I keep telling motherfuckers out here in Caliwack ass, I got eyes in places you can't see, and I love hunting in the rain, bitch. Ha ha, fuck that.
This is called Racial Profile. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't that he was 5'6" tall. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't that he weighed 150 pounds. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't the white. It was the color of his skin that scared them. The wallet was never a gun. It was the color of his skin that scared them. He looked like somebody capitalism taught them to kill. Somebody oppressed. Somebody exploited. Somebody from Africa, an immigrant. Somebody whose ancestors were slaves, like 3/5 of a person. Like somebody it would take 41 bullets to kill. He looked suspicious. Like something inhuman. Something it would take 41 bullets to kill. He looked like somebody capitalism taught them to kill. It wasn't about it. It was the color of his skin that determined his worth. Four racist cowards killed one Amadou Diallo 19 times. They should be in jail serving 41 plus 19 life sentences in consecutive order. I got it right, now tell me I got it. I got it right, now tell me I got it right. I got it right, now tell me I got it right. I got it right, now tell me I got it right. I got it right, now tell me I got it right.
Ah, yes, and now we come to the butt end of the show. And the only way to put a perspective on that which gives you a gas face, you gotta take both your thumbs and pry open the vertical mouthpiece and look that brown eye straight in the eye and pull the trigger on that person, place, or thing that's causing the madness and strife in your life. And on a 1, 2, 3 and a mighty woo-saw, just breathe in and stab the cabin as we count. A 1, a 2, a 3, and a mighty woo-saw, asshole of the day. Yo, George Zimmerman fans of the Stand Your Ground, because I'm a weak punk bitch who can't fight law, one of your own is going to fucking fry. And we're talking about some fucking straight up fucking like LSD fry here, alright? Time for some action on this shit, bitches. And this time, the stripes on this racist motherfucker has been exposed for what a murdering motherfucker of authority does, did, and influences the course of justice against us as a justifiable reason to kill black people. Check it. The execution by lethal injection for 56-year-old Manuel Pardo is set for 6 p.m. tonight in Florida State Prison at Stark Island. Okay? 9 people died at the hands of this maniac who were killed because he claimed his claim, okay, because his claim was that they were doing harm to the community as black drug dealers. Hey, thanks but no thanks. Bumpy Knuckles was running the coke line out of Florida during the crack wars during the 80s. You know, black, all the black in the day, Nino Brown shit, okay? And this Gusano took it upon himself to play heel, pretty much the way George Zimmerman's attorney wants his clients to be seen as after the trial. Not to mention that back, or black in the day, black babies were used as gator bait. Still marks testament to the overall disposability of black youth in this modern visualization of circumstances. Of course, you know what I'm saying. What the fuck? Okay? Put that poop throw on death row. Pardo's attorneys are trying to block his execution. They're arguing in federal appeals court that he's mentally ill, something his trial attorney believed more than 2 decades ago. That's 20 years, people. Oh, but they don't have a problem killing niggas suspected of having mental issues either, so get the fuck off that dick shit, will you? Since 1988, this asshole's been a mockery and a pariah to the justice system that seeks justice for some and none for justice. Especially when historically, when you have a good command of the English language and pass for white. Not only did he sell out his cultural identity above the ideology of justice and the idolatry that comes with it, he proved that a short dick spit will always side with a short dick cracker with the inflated use of a black phallic symbol of death to make justice as red, white, and blue-blooded as possible. Only this time, we get even and have solace that one motherfucker pays for his crimes. Yep, Manuel. I could have been top cop, but I'm about to get laid out like Pacquiao. Pardo, you are the first dead asshole cop of the day, right? That's right. Good night and say hello to hell when you get your bitch ass there, bitch.
Don't call me nigga. Don't call me white. Don't call me nigga. Don't call me white.
Yeah, if you missed it, then play it again till you get it. You can say moving forward like a bitch, but you know I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been your radio shows. Busted Ass Radio 83.17 FMX. And the X stands for you didn't see me coming when you never saw where I was at. All up in your ways. Stay the shit like in the room, boom, boom, harder than ever. Booty bubbles and dirty condoms. Music provided by Omega 7 Records, the Mothership Connection, and the underground music scene. Check us out at mush777.wix.com/bust.net/DAT/ass radio and leave a stinky on our blog Dirty Condoms, because it's all about cash or ass. So see you in the street, bitches. Or for the most part, don't walk past that damn lake. You might fuck around and slip in and drown your motherfucking asses. Bitch!